Hello, I'm Dr. Sanjay Panicker. I'm the founder and managing director of Amrita Homeopathy. We are placed in two locations. One is in Koramangala and the other is in Marathahalli in Bangalore. We specialize in hair and skin problems, respiratory problems, allergies, pediatrics, infertility, and gallstones. The most common reason why a male patient comes to me with baldness is androgenic alopecia, or otherwise called as male pattern of baldness. Baldness can be diffuse, like in male pattern of baldness, or it can be in one particular patch, patchy hair loss. Patchy hair loss is alopecia areata, alopecia totalis, that anyway gets covered by itself in many cases, and sometimes you may require medical intervention. But in diffuse hair loss, it can be two types, basically telogen effluvium, and it can be androgenic alopecia. Telogen effluvium is a hair loss which happens even from the sides and across the scalp. You have diffuse hair loss from everywhere. There, even if you do this, you will get hair fall. Whereas in androgenic alopecia, you will lose hair only in the crown area. First, the sides go deep, then the patch forms here. The patch becomes bigger, bigger, bigger through different stages, through seven stages, and then finally the person becomes bald. Usually, they say the person passes through one grade every year. There are seven grades. So grade one is when the sides go a little deep. Grade two is when it goes a little more deeper. Grade three is when it goes even more deeper up to here. You can see almost to the level of the ear. Grade four is when the patch starts forming here. Grade five is when the patch reaches almost till the middle of your vertex. And grade six is when the entire hair here is becoming very sparse. And grade seven is when the whole area becomes smooth. This is how you have seen men going bald. This hair is intact. Whereas in telogen effluvium, the backside hair is also lost. So in androgenic alopecia, which is the most common type that we encounter baldness, where the back hair is intact and the crown hair is lost. In telogen effluvium, the hair on the, across the scalp is lost. There is a diffuse hair loss from all across the scalp. Whereas in androgenic alopecia, only the crown area is lost and then the back hair is still saved. Now in androgenic alopecia, there are different reasons why the person may develop this. The most common is a genetic factor. Like somebody in the family has got baldness, father, father's brothers, grandparents, somebody you inherited that gene. But this androgenic alopecia is a baldness which has to come usually in the old age, like after 45, 50. But if people in their younger age is developing it, then there is something wrong. So it need not be a genetic factor. This is a gene for baldness which has to come in old age, okay? That is androgenic alopecia. As the age increases, this baldness usually can come up. But if it is happening in a younger age, then you must think of other factors as the possible causes. It can be hormonal, like it can be due to thyroid, or it can be even if your sugar levels are getting fluctuated, or it could be other hormonal reasons like your testosterone levels getting altered. In androgenic alopecia, what is happening is that the hormone testosterone has a derivative called as dihydro testosterone, which comes and blocks the root of the hair. And so the nutrition what is supposed to reach the hair will not reach. And so even if you eat the best to best food, if your hair is not getting the nutrition, a thick hair falls and a thin hair grows. Thin hair falls, thinner hair grows, and eventually nothing grows. And gradually the area becomes like your normal skin on the back of your hand. So it gets smoother on top of the head. Now, other than genetic factors and hormonal factors, even change of water, high stress levels, poor diet, not eating the right kind of food, and not applying the right kind of cosmetics on the scalp, not using the right kind of shampoos, not using the right kind of oils, all these can be triggers. Trigger means the starting point, why they started off. Even after some illness like typhoid, malaria, jaundice, after COVID, people have lost a lot of hair. So even other conditions like certain medication, like after anti-malarial medicines, after typhoid medicines, after BP medicines, and even certain medicines like minoxidil and finasteride. Actually, the funny part, it is used for the growth of the hair and it does produce growth. But then when the patient becomes irregular or when the patient is not using it, the baldness progresses so fast that what has to come at the rate of one grade every year, where the baldness will come by the second year, you go to the second grade, you will actually develop a patch within 5 or 6 months itself. The speed becomes double. The baldness speed starts becoming double. So in these kind of conditions where the baldness is progressing very fast in androgenic alopecia, homeopathic medicines have got a wonderful role to play. We have usually treated this with a constitutional approach, understanding the state of mind of the person and the personality type of the person. Mind also has got an effect on the body. When you're angry, in your body adrenaline is produced, that affects the body in certain ways. When you're sad, certain other chemicals are released, that affects the body in certain other ways. So it's important to know what is your state of mind, your personality type, your stress levels, how it is connected with the problem that you're facing. This assessment will give us an idea about what medicine that we need to give to this particular patient. The most common medicines which is used for hair loss is Jabrandi, Wiesbaden and such kind of things, which may work, may not work. But what will actually work is your constitutional approach. To understand the personality of the person, to understand the problem that he has undergone in his life, how his body has reacted, what is his body nature. This complete understanding will help us to treat the case. We also need to know if there are any other deficiencies, B12 deficiency, ferritin deficiency, folic acid, vitamin D, or if there's any of the hormonal issues in the background, like the thyroid. And then we're talking about men, but in women, also the polycystic ovarian disease can be, ovaries also, cysts also secrete certain amount of testosterone. And if your skin is already sensitive to that little quantity of testosterone, testosterone comes and blocks the route to the hair and the nutrition to the hair is lost. And only the crown area hair has got receptors which can attract this hormone towards it. And so people with this type of baldness will go bald only in the crown and not in the back of the head, because back of the head, there are no receptors which can attract the hormone. So that's how this baldness progresses. So when you know the causes, when you know that, okay, this is best treated with natural methods of treatment, then I think that's the best thing to do. In my experience, people have always got anxious when they see the hair loss, and they become so anxious. And even though the hair loss may not have come under control, that hair loss has been replaced by the body. It is not the loss which is important. It is how much you're growing back which is more important. Don't get worried when you see the hair which is clogging your bathroom drain, or don't see the hair which is falling on your floor and get worried. You also need to understand how much you're growing back. If your volume is reducing despite having minimal loss or by losing more or whatever, then you need to seek medical attention. This has been my experience of dealing with hair loss issues.